So it wasn't premeditation. You don't.
No.
You can't say this
I
was a premeditated.
I can't say with 100% certainty that he premeditated that while I was sitting in that jury room. I can't say that.
But you do see extreme atrocity or cruelty.
I see extreme atrocity and cruelty.
In was it what the number of shots?
That it was his indifference, and that was part of what I had to look at. And it was, even if there was no premeditation, he could have made choices there when he was there. He was there, they admitted that. And he could have made different choices, and he chose not to.
I think one thing in that regard that surprised a lot of us was that indifference. And we watched the video footage at his home later in the morning or early afternoon after the incident occurred. And he was just lounging around by the pool and playing with the baby and just going about his regular life. I mean, you know, for us to have knowledge that he was there at the time that his close friend was murdered, personally, there's no way I could just carry on hours later like nothing ever happened. That's indifference.
So those videotapes, in particular his own security camera tapes, were crucial to
hours
you.
Later. Yeah. Hours
yes,
later.
Definitely.
But in the instructions, we weren't asked to use that after the murder to weigh our decision to leave your friend on the ground.
That's
knowing it. That he's not there anymore. He's either dead or he's going to die. That's indifference. He didn't need to pull the trigger. He could have made different choices when that man was lying there.
Extreme cruelty. How did some of you else? I'm sorry to not know all of your names mm-hmm. right away because I liked it, but so I hate to be sort of saying you all. So please don't think I'm rude. But were there other signs to you of extreme cruelty, or?
For me, it was, somebody had mentioned that, well, it was a gun. So for me, trying to think about extreme cruelty, what are we talking about? Are we talking about somebody physically cutting off someone's arm and letting them bleed to death? Is that extreme cruelty? Or is it the fact that, for me, it was a gun. You took a weapon, it didn't matter. You shot him once, but you kept going and you shot him six times. There's just no need for that. And there's no need to use the gun, period. No need to use the gun. So for me, and on my personally, it was about the gun. It was about taking that weapon, knowing what you're going to do, and shooting somebody and killing them. That's pretty cruel.
One shot was enough for me. There was no need for the other five. One shot for me is cruelty. Anybody who can pick up a gun, point it to someone, and shoot them is cruelty.
And it didn't have to be him. It didn't.
Right. Right.
It didn't
have to be him.
Do you feel like he did pull the trigger, or do you know?
I don't know. There's no evidence to support that he pulled the trigger. But he chose not to do anything about it.
And in that moment or in the aftermath?
Exactly. In that moment is what I was looking at, because that's what I was instructed to do in that moment.
He played a role.
Yeah.
Whether he was the shooter or the transport, he played a role mm-hmm. in that murder, and that's what he was charged with.